Today was the deadline to file for office in Kansas. No Democrat filed for Congress, meaning Kevin Yoder of Johnson County is almost assured re-election.
And because Kansas changed its political maps last week, it was a hectic day in politics. KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney has the story. Michael?
The deadline passed at noon today, and there were quite a few surprises.
Yoder was expected to be a heavy favorite for re-election. Now a second term is almost a certainty. This is what Kansas' four congressional districts looked like for the last 10 years. Now, because of population shifts, they have to be redrawn after every census, and so this is what the new map looks like. Because a panel of federal judges finished the work last week, lots of candidates were lined up in Topeka today, filing for office since the state district lines were also changed.
So it's been a mad scramble.
Ronnie Metzger is the head of the dominant Johnson County Republican Party. Now, right after the new maps came out, two veteran Republican state senators from Johnson County, John Brattle and Terry Huntington, announced their retirements. At the State House today, they were watching Johnson County's 30th House District, because two incumbents, Lance Kinzer and Ron Worley, are now running against each other in the GOP primary. And so are state reps Mike Kigrel and Arlen Siegfried. That's District 121, another Johnson County House race. Now, the new maps give Johnson County more political clout because it's growing so much. For example, Olathe is getting its own state Senate district. Its population is up 35% since 2000.
It's great that our voice is not diluted necessarily with other communities of other interests and other priorities. It's great to have a dedicated Senate district and one that's pretty much going to be an Olathe senator. We're very grateful for that.
So Olathe gets its Senate district, which it wanted. Johnson County gets a bigger voice in Topeka, which it wanted. And Kansas Republicans get lots of primaries, which they didn't want. Michael Mahoney, KMBC 9 News. Back to you.
Michael, thank you for the latest on all that. Another Kansas congressman, Tim Huelskamp, didn't have anybody file for office against him in western Kansas, so he's basically assured a second term.